Hi, my name's Mark DiGiulio. I work at Barry Plant Manningham in Victoria. And we're here today because I have recently won the 2014/15 REIV Salesperson Non-Principal Agent of the Year. The recipe for success, there isn't one. It just really depends on the individual and how motivated. The best part about the job that I do, and most agents will understand this, is you can work as hard or as soft as you want to. From my perspective though, we play hard, we go out there, we want to win, and we want to make every post a winner. So what Barry Plant do differently in comparison to our competitors is at our auctions we use an easel. It's basically a big board. We write up all the bids on the board so it is open, it is transparent. We have two texters, there's a black texter, a red texter. All the bids are written up in black texter to the point of when it changes to red. When it changes to red, property is on the market. We have met the reserve price and our marketplace is educated to understand this. It cuts out all the BS, it cuts out all the fluff. People don't ask the question, is it on the market, is it on the market? The auctions run a lot smoother and we get better prices because people don't have buyer's remorse. They don't have an opportunity to think. I just find that from our point of view, it's a great point of difference in the marketplace. Not only that, we do little things like I have branded water bottles. We have a coffee cart that's branded. We have Barry the Bear. So the opening bidder at all our auctions will get Barry the Bear. There's a Facebook page and a blog. People are chasing these teddies at the moment. So we find almost at every auction we get an opening bid and it's great. You know, kids want it. All the kids are putting their hands up in the air. Mum and dad are having heart attacks. And, you know, we're trying to stop these kids from buying the properties as well as the bears. So it's a fun environment. So I think with the auctions, if they're done correctly, you can truly pick up some great business. I like to refer to myself as a new age auctioneer. I think the old school style of being aggressive, yelling at people, scaring them with first, second, third, final calls, I don't subscribe to that. I do it, don't get me wrong, but I balance it out very nicely, I believe, to the point where I'm not a comedian by any means, but I'm engaging, I'm friendly, and it does bring a more authentic human touch to it. And I think the auctioneers that can convey that message across with their own personality are the ones that will pick up more business. I go around to a number of auctions and I even have some of my vendors that are shopping at auctions, and I'm sure your viewers, they have vendors shopping at auctions, and I get a lot of people calling me saying, Mark, you're just so much more entertaining. And I like to think my auctions are entertaining, and that's where I think our point of difference is in the marketplace. Generally speaking, I'll get up in the morning, probably around 5:30. At 6 o'clock, I'm into the gym. You know, just keeping fit, I find that there's a direct correlation between your personal health and obviously your work life. I find when I get into the office by, you know, 7:30, 8 o'clock, I'm buzzing, bouncing off the walls. We start calling our vendors and getting all the important hard tasks out of the way. From there, pretty much between, say, 9 o'clock to about 12, I'm doing vendor meetings and buyer appointments. From 12 o'clock onwards, I'm in market appraisals. When I get back to the office, I'm answering emails, speaking with my team, getting a debrief on what's happened on the day and making those important calls and, you know, writing the reports and doing what I have to do before close of business. We then get home, have some dinner and have a bit of a family life, and it starts all over again. So that's a very short version of what we probably do.